Well, Christmas has come and gone, and the Dayton area still waiting on a major gift. The city still owed $500,000 for hosting the Racino, which opened back in August. The city thought it had a deal worked out until the governor's veto on that plan. Now at 5, Jordan Burgess looks at if the city will still get that money.
Leaders here at City Hall in Dayton say they're counting on that money from the Racino, and by law, they're supposed to get it. So we're asking what continues to be the holdup.
In the race for cash, Dayton thought it had crossed the finish line, only to come up short again.
We were really disappointed. We felt like the House and Senate had spoken in a bipartisan manner.
A section of a bill passed by the Ohio House and Senate worked out a method to pay Dayton the $500,000 fee it's owed for hosting Hollywood Gaming at Dayton Raceway. But Governor John Kasich vetoed that section.
The governor's office says that to give them a few days and they'll try to find a resolution.
The bill would have made Penn Gaming pay half the fee, and Ohio paid the other half from the $150 million already paid to the state by Penn. In his veto, Kasich indicated the money should come from Penn and not at all from the state. Penn Gaming has argued the money should entirely come from what it's already paid the state.
Of course, it's the governor's say, so if he wants, Penn Gaming to pay all of it, he can make that happen, or he can make the state happen, but he needs to do something to make something happen.
Everyone agrees Dayton should get the money. The city is including it in its budget, a budget already suffering from a cut of $1.4 million because of the elimination of traffic cameras.
Another $500,000 would be tough, so we're hoping that the state will come through.
We wanted to know what the chances are that something gets done.
Is this something you think you'll get eventually?
We hope so. We hope so. You never know what's going on in Columbus, but we hope that they'll be good to their word on it.
And the mayor hopes that something can get done early next year to work out where this money is going to come from for Dayton. Jordan Burgess, 2 News, working for you.